Hey everybody, how you doing? Just gonna bring you a quick little video of the BuddiStick Pro. I'm not putting it together, I'm not taking it down, and I'm not even using it in this video. The purpose of this video is just to slow things down a little bit and give you a little bit closer look at some things of the antenna I've discovered and I want to pass on to you. That's what the community is about. That's what radio is about to me, is everybody trying their own thing. This works, this don't work. Hey, in case of this, here's this, blah, blah, blah. So I wanted to record a video and I wanted to share some of this stuff with you. So hang tight. The telescopic whip that comes with it. One thing that you want to make sure of, be a little careful of, when you're extending this out, sometimes you may think you got all the sections out, but you see this right here? There's two more sections right there. I ain't even pulled them all the way out, you know? The first time I put this up, well, I couldn't really figure out how to make it tune. I realized I still had a section or two of this telescopic whip that wasn't extended out all the way. And with it being all the same color and darkened color, sometimes it's easy to overlook that. There's a tip there for you. This here, the Versa Hub, neat little gadget. It's got your standard tripod mount on the bottom, so you can use your own tripod if you wish. Now, some of you familiar with the BuddiStick Pro already knows that this is not factory. Let's find the camera here. I acquired this from a hardware store because I lost on my first POTA adventure the little thumb screw that holds the elevated radio wire on. And I had some people tell me that, hey, your extra coil taps will fit that. Well, I'd already tried that, and I'll show you. The extra little tap covers that come with it, they're threaded on the inside, but they just slip right on and off. So they're bigger than that bolt is. So anyway, I believe this was a 1024. I'll update the description if that's incorrect. Coming in a two-pack, fits on there extremely nice. It's made out of brass, so it's shiny. If you drop it in the grass with a little bit of sunlight or a flashlight, you have a lot better luck of finding this thing than you would with the factory one that come all black. So even if you haven't lost this yet, I would highly suggest next time you're around a hardware store, go look for this part. I'll put the link in the description or description of it anyway, so you can find it at your local stores. And look, I bought it for a two pack for like $1.50, $1.48 actually. So that's another little tip I've come up with using the antenna. Also, I just picked this up out of the Walmart camping supplies, so you can put it under your tripod and hook your tripod to it if you don't want to hang your bag from it or something like that. Yeah, here it is. So, yep, my mistake, it's a 10-32. 10-32. And it come in a two pack, so I've still got an extra. So definitely get you some of these just to keep in your bag. Now the shock cord legs, I want to say I seen a comment from an individual yesterday in one of the chats, and he mentioned that he broke his shock cord. I don't know if that was under normal use or that he extended it maybe too far and overstressed it. I'm not sure, but that's something to keep in mind. And another great reason to keep an extra camera tripod with you, so that if something does happen to your shock cord, which you could replace, repair on your own, you could use your extra camera tripod mount or something on the Versa Hub. Elevated radio wire. It's It's got these markings on it that you can see throughout the wire. Those, of course, are your approximate locations for the different bands pre-marked to get you in the ballpark. Now, I do highly recommend that you probably want a nano VNA or an analyzer, a rig expert stick, MFJ, whatever analyzer you got, will make your life a little easier on getting this thing tuned. But with these pre-marked areas on this elevated radio for the bands, it's not necessary if your radio that you're using has a built-in SWR meter. In case I use a 705 or the 7300, it has an SWR function that you can measure SWR points. You get this thing pretty close and you may see where it dips, and then you can make your adjustment. You don't absolutely have to have an analyzer to use this antenna and get it tuned. It will make your life a little easier, but you can do it with just the meter on your radio and using those pre-marked locations. I left coil on. I believe this one might have been, turn it up the right way. This was either 17 or 20 meters that I had this tuned for at the time, and this was 40 meters. 40 meters is, on the instructions, I think it said 39, coil 39, and that bottom one. You see these blue and black marks here? See that? Those are in increments of 5, so you just do 5, 10, 15, 20, so on, to get you a little rapid more of a count. You want to start from the top and count down. So this would be coil 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. Now this may sound a little redundant at this time because there's instruction manuals for it now, and it kind of explains life a little more simpler. When I first got the BuddiStick Pro, the instruction manual was not out yet, so I had to learn the hard way on some of this stuff. I usually do leave at least these two coil taps on the coil. Some have suggested not to do that, because if one of these works loose, and you see, I finger tight, just as soon as it's a little snug, I quit. Barely put any pressure on these, because the more you twist down, the more it's gonna deform the wire going through the coil there. And I wanna try to keep that down to a minimum. But doing that, it's real easy. You go to change these out, you barely bump it, so I barely touch that one, now it's loose. So if it's loose, then it's more than likely, very possibly, touching more than two coil marks here and shortening out, and that's really going to throw off your tuning and SWR. If you're going to leave more than one on there, just double check that it's snug and not rattling around. You know, just give it a little snug, that's it. Don't over tighten it, because you're going to damage something if you tighten it down too much. I hope something in that you found a little helpful. You probably have seen that it does work. I'll tell you, I took this and set it up at the my first park activation with the group of the Area 51. And my very first contact was on 17 meters to Panama. That was a pretty good haul from Mississippi. So I was quite pleased with that. It was a 5.9 contact both ways. My very next contact after that was about 15 miles down the road by ground wave. You can work ground wave and you can work DX. This is my thoughts on it. I do not regret getting this antenna. The only time I got upset so far is when I lost that little thumb screw right there. But then I got happy again when I found it at a hardware store. And I have to give props to Shane, K5QBF, for he sent me a picture of some links online of some of these, and I went to the hardware store and found them. You can see there's not a lot of clearance between where the antenna mounts up here and the thumb screw. Very little. So somebody suggested a wing nut. Well, there's no way a wing nut was gonna clear that, so that's perfect. Rewind the video or look at the description again for that, because that's gonna be a very important part that you're gonna want to pick up on your own. That's all I got. I'm finna go back in the shack, find some more stations playing POTA. 73.